Hickory is a really rural community.
We're surrounded by a really rural, mountainous area. Beautiful area and really nice place to live.
It's blue collar predominantly. It seems like the kind of community where people might still leave their car doors unlocked, maybe their house door unlocked.
Very tight knit. Families have known each other for a very, very long time.
You can tell there's a sense of community, but it's also kind of isolated. You can go to Hickory and you can get lost.
I was working the weekend shift when the call came in that an Amber Alert had been issued. We'd never had an Amber Alert here in the county before.
10-year-old Zahra Baker is missing. Her father and stepmother say they last saw the little girl with brown hair, blue eyes, and freckles in her bedroom asleep at about 2:30 a.m. the morning of Saturday, October 9th.
Catawba County 911.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm good.
I need police.
Secret police 911. What is your emergency?
Yeah, my daughter is missing.
I'm sorry? Your daughter is missing?
Yes, yes.
The 911 call is disturbing. You hear a man say, my daughter's missing. She's gone, and he doesn't sound all that upset about it.
So no one has seen your daughter since 2:30 this morning?
No, like I said, we had all that drama last night, and me and my wife went back to bed. And my daughter's, I think, coming into puberty, so she's hitting that broody stage. So we only see her when she comes out, when she wants something, and that's about it.
The call reporting Zahra missing is not the first time that day the Baker family had called 911. The first call came at 5 a.m. that morning.
My husband works for a tree maintenance company, and our backyard's on fire.
Your what's on fire?
The backyard. We've got big mulch piles and wood piles because we sell firewood and stuff.
Adam worked for a company that mulched and shipped wood. The backyard of the house had so much room that sometimes they would bring some of that material to that location. They would chip the wood and then they would haul it out.
They had reported a fire, like an arson type thing, with a ransom note attached to a vehicle out in the front yard.
The ransom note said, no cops. No cops was written on the ransom note twice. No cops. $1 million. We have your daughter, and your red-headed pot-smoking son is next.
The note is directed at Adam Baker's boss, Mark Coffey, who owns the home where the Bakers are living.
The homeowner, he didn't live there. It was a rental house. He had a teenage daughter. They thought maybe someone had come to try to kidnap the teenage daughter.
After the fire was extinguished and they had confirmed that Adam Baker's boss's daughter had not been kidnapped, Adam and Elisa Baker say they went back to bed and didn't check on their daughter, Zahra, until about 8 hours later.
The police were out here last night. They were firing a ransom note for my boss's daughter. I got up this a little while ago, and it appears they took my daughter instead of my boss's daughter.
How long has she been missing?
We checked in there last night about 2:30, and she was there, and all this happened last night about 5 o'clock, so I don't know if they set a fire in the yard to distract us to go out, and wasn't they snuck in the door, or I don't know.
Okay, I'm not familiar with what happened last night. What happened last night?
Last night, we were woken up. My dog woke me up, and I had a fire in the backyard, and somebody had put gas in my company vehicle that I drive for work. They left a ransom note on the company vehicle to my boss saying they had his daughter and his son was next. And his daughter's fine. His daughter came with him here last night when I called him. And it appears they may have taken my daughter instead of his daughter.
Okay, do you know who this was?
I don't know who it was.
That may have taken her?
No, ma'am.
Do you have any idea why they were threatening to take his daughter?
I don't know.
Okay, what's your name?
My name is Adam Baker.
Everything about it seems strange. I have never heard of a kidnapping that started with a fire in the backyard or where the kidnapper may have grabbed the wrong person.
It isn't a typical kidnapping, and Zahra Baker isn't a typical victim.
She had cancer when she was younger.
The first time she had been diagnosed with cancer, it took her leg. And the second time when the cancer came back, the treatments took her hearing.
Coincidentally, she had been part of a news story several months earlier.
So Charlotte Motor Speedway has the hearing aid giveaway. I walked over to Zahra and introduced myself, and you know, she was looking up at me and eager to talk and was waiting her turn for her hearing test.
A lot of people don't understand that treatment does tend to take other things away from you. She's determined. She wants to go to college. She can hear now. It's been a blessing.
This little girl said that when kids make fun of her for losing her leg, she tells them a crocodile bit it off. You'll never forget a little girl who survived cancer.
And did you say that she was handicapped?
Yes, ma'am. She has above the knee amputation.
Okay, she has one leg.
One leg, yes,
that's
ma'am.
Partially amputated?
Yeah, she has a prosthetic leg, which apparently they're taking with her.
If you were going to kidnap a child, having that prosthetic leg would make them more mobile, and it just didn't make a lot of sense. The other thing was the fact that she had her hearing aids, that she had left those behind.
Of course, we started looking, you know, searching the house and surrounding neighborhoods and interviewing him, Adam Baker, and Elisa, and figured out something just wasn't quite right.
Based on interviews with Zahra's father and stepmother, investigators are struggling to figure out when was the last time anyone outside the immediate family actually saw Zahra.
At this point in the investigation, we are having a very difficult time establishing a true timeline. We are looking for the public to help us. We are running out of time, folks. The longer this thing goes, the likelihood this outcome will not be positive. So please, we need help.
The case immediately attracted media attention, not just locally, but nationally, and even internationally.
She was from Australia. This girl could have easily been taken back to Australia by her mother. That was one thing that we were thinking about, is she even in the country?
Zahra's biological mother gave up her parental rights when Zahra was around 1 year old.
Adam took custody of Zahra when her mother suffered from postpartum depression. Then Adam meets Elisa.
Adam Baker and Zahra settled in North Carolina, where Adam's new wife, Elisa, or just Lisa to some of her friends and family, was from. But the family moved around a lot.
They had only been in that house on 21st Avenue for less than a year.
That was Lisa Baker's lifestyle. Even before she met Adam, she was known to move from place to place pretty frequently. Zahra didn't have an extended period in any particular school because of all the moving around. When she went missing, she had been listed with the state as a homeschooler.
When the police chief said she was homeschooled, you know, it hit me like a ton of bricks. That was there potential that she had not been seen by other people since May, when her teacher referred her to that hearing aid event? Like, was it that long that she had been missing?
It took some time for us to come up with a 2-week timeline prior to Elisa and Adam reporting her missing. That's the best we could narrow it down to, as far as the last time anybody had seen Zahra.
Nobody in the neighborhood had ever seen Zahra. I went door to door asking people, what was she like? And people were shocked that a little girl had lived in that house, because she didn't play outside, certainly didn't play with other children. She was completely isolated. She was an invisible child in a lot of ways.
Without a solid timeline to determine when exactly Zahra disappeared, the focus shifts to other strange facets of the case.
We are questioning the validity of that note. We have no further demands from that note.
There was a wood chipper in the backyard. First thing on the investigation scene at the house was a wood chipper. Did her body get put into the wood chipper?